So one of the I think one of the best stories in your movie, On the Sly, In Search of the Family Stone, we're here with Michael Rubinstone, who put that whole thing together, is the Paul Shafer bit, because Sly had been out of, he'd been out of play, he'd been out of the public eye for years, right? Years and years and years, right? Again, he had put some albums out, but he wasn't out, right? He was a recluse. He would just pop albums out. And then he shows up on the David Letterman show in the mid-80s, like out of the blue. How did I miss this? And Paul Shafer has a really great story in your movie about how he plays, right? He comes in, he talks a little bit. And if you watch the interview, you can tell he's kind of, he ain't engaged. And then he goes and he plays. And Paul Shafer comes up to say, "Hey, man, it's an honor to play with you. You're a legend. I just want to let you know how much this meant to me." And Sly's like, "Yeah, yeah. Hey, can I borrow $100? So like, Paul's like, "Okay, here. Guess whatever."
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, I mean, I think that, you know, that says a lot about where Sly was at the time. I think at that time he, you know, in the interview, he seems kind of like, I don't know, just a little desperate, you know, like almost a cry for help. But at the same time, there is something that I didn't put in the film, and Paul Shafer has always given me for it because I didn't put, it's like, "Michael, you need to put in the tag." Years later, Bobby Womack is playing the Letterman show, and he comes over to Shafer, pulls out $100 and says, "Hey, Sly told me to give you this."
Oh my God. Of course, it probably was not Sly's money. He's probably saying, "Can you pay?"
I have no idea. I don't even know if it's true. But Paul says it happened. I trust Paul, I'm going to go with the myth.
Hey, if you like what you hear, like and subscribe. It really means a lot, and we would love to have you coming back every week. Thank you.